What's going on, losers? My camera's kind of beat. We're gonna have to buy a new one soon. Anyways, so we posted something on Instagram yesterday or the day before. This is Thursday, but we posted it like Monday. Yeah, check out the camera. It's hilarious. Anyways, fender mirrors. So we're gonna do some fender mirrors today. Bo's going inside to get a tape measure and a Sharpie. We're going to try and figure out like where to put it. I guess a lot of people say to mount them like even with the front of the tire. So it's like there-ish. But we're going to go here. We're going to put it center of the tire. And then just like back a little bit. So kind of like two-thirds of the way down the fender.
Start shooting without me?
Yeah, I told him you were inside getting some stuff because you weren't prepared. Now he's prepared.
Totally prepared. So what do you think? Center of the tire?
Yeah, I think like right here. Just off center of the tire.
So front like two-thirds.
Yeah, exactly. Right. That's okay. What I was thinking. Cool. So, okay. He's gonna get some stuff. So here's our marks. We measured from right here at this corner, 26 inches down, and that's our back hole. So from there to there, 26 inches. Came over here and did the same. I don't know if you guys can see them, it's in the black over here. And then we did 1 inch this way, and that's where we're gonna put our punch marks, and then we'll drill the holes, and then I think we're gonna have to take the fenders off and bolt those on, and then put the fenders back on.
You will need to take the fenders off?
Yeah, how are you going to get to the nuts on the back side? Magic. Well, no, that wouldn't. No, it's a lip that it goes on.
Is it what?
There's a lip that the fender sits on.
Oh, right on.
That's my new Forester. I love it. What are you doing now?
Opening the hood so we can take the fenders off.
Oh, okay.
Daddy.
Let's take this off.
Oh, yeah?
You gotta open the door, and there's two in there. You gotta take the bumper off. Oh, no, on yours you might not have to. Yep. You gotta take the bumper off. You gotta take these off. Kind of a big ordeal to get fenders off on these things. We might be able to jack it up and use an extension to get up in there. You have a fender liner, but we might be able to do it. I was thinking about this lip here.
Yeah.
But if you look here, well, it looks like we might be able to get up in there. Take the fender liner out and the tire off.
Well, that'd be easier than taking all of this off.
Yeah, it's a lot to take off to get a fender off. Alright, so we're gonna try that. We're gonna try and take the tire off, see if we can't reach up in there. Bo's a nerd and has fender liners. What a nerd. My truck doesn't even have like fender wells anymore. Like, we cut all this out. The noisiest thing in the world, right there. Okay. So we're gonna get the tire off. We're gonna see about the fender liner, see if we can't get to them. And we'll catch you guys up in a minute. So hold on.
So we've moved to up under the truck here. We had to peel this this fender liner out. Ronnie thinks I'm a nerd for having a fender liner. But it's got like a really crazy amount of screws in it. I don't know if you can see. There's like probably 20 screws up under here. It's fairly ridiculous. Anyway, so once we peel the fender liner out, we can get to the flat spot up in the fender. And we made little punches right here. We're about to drill holes. And hopefully this will go fairly smoothly from there.
Oh my goodness.
My goodness. I watched a few videos
on this. Yeah. And this was the part that people hated the most. They like, because they were putting fender mirrors on their fairly classic cars, you know, and they're like, this is like the scariest part, was drilling holes in your like, nice fenders.
Old Corollas and old
Cortinas and stuff like
What's
that.
What's that one car that looks kind of good? I love it. What is it?
That one car?
Yeah, I love it up until now. And it has like bug eyes on it. It's made by Toyota too. I can't think of it. I had a brain fart.
I don't know. We'll be back after Ronnie's brain fart. So, our holes were a little too close together, so we had to walk them out a little bit, make them into ovals instead of circles. But after all said and done,
dang, bro, dude,
look at that.
All right, so are now we just doing that one?
Okay, now who thinks we should keep all four mirrors on the car?
You could do like these for like normal, and then just set those up for like your blind spot.
Dude, what a great idea.
Yeah.
Or I could just put a giant mirror right here, just one giant mirror, so I could see everything.
And then you have a blind spot over here in front of you.
Good call, good call. All right, so let's see.
Are we going to bolt it down? Yes, Carissa has them. They're right here.
I've got them right here. The ones that I need. Make sure which one fits this one. Those are the extras.
It came with four?
Yeah,
that's
it
cool.
Came with four. I don't really know why, but it came with four.
So $40 kit. The mirrors were questionable quality, we'll say.
they just feel super light. Like
yeah.
Crazy light feel.
They look okay, like time will tell, because the only thing you worry about with like mirrors is the actual mirror like coming loose.
Yeah.
But it came with four seals. So that's probably worth at least like $20 right there. So half of it you get in seals.
Alright,
let's put it on.
Let's see how it do. Hold that there, steady, and not get douchebag in the process.
That's impossible.
I know that's the hardest part.
I mean, I do drive a Forester now, so maybe I'm a little less douchey.
Whatever.
It's not an STI.
I can see it really good. It's at a weird height to where if I lay on my back, I probably won't be able to
reach it.
I need like
You need one of those special creepers that like jack you up and stuff?
Jack it up real
quick. Oh dude, look at this dude over here. Can you guys see that? He's on his little moped thing.
Oh,
alright, we'll be back in a minute.
Surprise visit from the Badger. Oh gross, dude. He brought by his rallycross vehicle. The Hoopty. It's pretty gutted inside. But that's okay. Like I said, it's just his rallycross vehicle. Anyways, I finished getting the first mirror on. It's all tightened down and everything. Looks good.
Were you really concerned about the stock gearbox?
Fit really well. Like I said, once you got this fender liner out, it was really easy to get to the that flat spot on the fender. We just had to crank those nuts down, and that was pretty much it.
And the stock gearbox.
I don't know what they're talking about. I don't care. I'm going to put this other fender mirror on, and then we'll get y'all some pictures and video of, like, cruising around. Oh, and we also have to figure out what to do with these. Obviously, we're taking them off, but we need to figure out some sort of block-off plate for this right here.
So here it is, man. Fender mirrors. Sit in there, bud. Let's see what you think. Oh, he's trying to fix this thing. So how do you adjust these?
You have to have a really long arm. Like, you have to have somebody crawl out on the hood and just adjust them.
Okay.
And you have to have some sort of like headset so you can talk to them and say, you know, more to the right, more to the left. But then they're looking back this way and you're looking that way. So when you say right and they move it to their right and you meant your right. So these don't get adjusted.
Can you see anything?
Let me see this. There.
It's not affecting it.
Is it not?
No, it doesn't.
Well, it bothers me.
I know, it bugs me too.
The Google Eyes don't bother me though. Especially that one's bigger than the other one.
This camera's a little worn out.
Yeah, it's a special camera.
So.
All right, so. Push the outside in toward you a little bit. Yeah, that's good.
Okay.
Maybe a little more
out.
Yeah, that's good. Right there.
Okay.
And the other one's like pointed at the sun or something.
It looks pretty sharp. But I feel like it needs more low now.
It definitely needs more low.
We
put one of my wheels on earlier and they look tiny with the wheels and tires. So it definitely needs more low.
It was pretty funny.
It needs to go down at least two, three more inches. Definitely. So we'll be
drop spindles?
That. I don't know. I don't know what we're going to do about getting more low on here.
Drop spindles?
I mean, as for right now, I can lower the jack and that'll make it lower.
Oh, dang. Currently, it's not rubbing here, so I know it's not at ride height.
All right.
Did you break it?
I don't know. I'm not
here. By jacking it up?
It looks good, though.
It does. We gotta make a plate to go here, so it doesn't look so jank. We were talking about taking the... Kimberly had this idea of taking the factory mirror and cutting it off.
Cutting that off right there?
And maybe
doing a little fiberglass work or something to smooth it out.
That's aluminum. You probably just got Paul welded.
Oh, it is aluminum. Yeah, and you just screw it back on the factory position.
Done deal.
Okay.
Done deal.
So we'll figure that out another time. For right now, I'm just gonna drive around and enjoy my fender mirrors.
Do you have a link for these?
The link will be in the video
description below.
Levi.
Description below. Yes, that sort of thing.
What's next?
What is next?
Re-indexing?
Yeah, we're doing a re-indexing of the torsion bars on the truck. And we're also going to tell you all about a website that you can go to get some different torsion bars, some stronger torsion bars. They're like heavy-duty torsion bars, and they're supposed to add 20 to 30% more strength to the front end, which would probably be good for drifting,
yeah.
I think. So we're going to try that. Good for lowering as well, so we're going to try that.
Levi.
They weren't expensive. They're like 200 something bucks.
200. I think they were 200. Something like that. Exactly 209 right now.
Yeah. And I'm probably going to get some of these LRB speed door panels for my car.
So lame.
You're lame. Ronnie wants to make his own because he thinks he's that good. Levi, we're trying to make a video.
It's literally a flat piece of metal. How could you mess it up?
Hey, I could mess it up. All right? I could mess it up.
So, speaking of, he probably could mess it up. We took the mirrors off, and I put my little trim back on over there. I don't know if you can see it, like right there. What the heck, Bo?
I didn't put mine back on because I'm dumb. Now I've got to take the door card off just to put that little plastic piece back on. How dumb is that?
Oh goodness.
We wanted to show y'all something. When we were taking this door card off, it took us forever to figure out how to get this trim off. We watched a video on YouTube, and this guy was like, hey, just pull on the bottom of the door. Like, this pulls out, and you just pull on the bottom, and it pops right off. It's super easy.
It was pretty amazing.
It was super amazing, because I pried on it with a screwdriver on all four sides, and it wouldn't come off. But you just pull the door, and it pops right off. It's crazy.
It kind of, like, goes into the stratosphere. If you pull too hard, yours was like, wham! But, yeah, that makes it a lot easier. Anyways, truck looks pretty cool.
Fender mirror challenge.
I am
completed.
So you guys were bugging us. We posted this on Monday.
Yeah.
That we got these in, I don't know what, within the first 30 minutes.
Yeah, we got like 5 or 6 messages about, hey, when y'all gonna have the fender mirror video up? When are y'all gonna put the fender mirrors on? I've been trying to do this. Where'd you get these? What'd you search? All that kind of stuff. So search D21 fender mirrors on eBay, and they pop up. They come from China. They took like 2 weeks to get here.
Really, 2 weeks?
Yeah, but they weren't expensive. I think they were like 40 bucks.
Did you have them on Amazon?
I didn't look.
Why didn't you look on Amazon?
I don't know.
That's our go-to.
Is it?
It's my go-to.
Anyway, so that's it for today.
Bye.